First, we create a new account.
Choose the username and password.
Confirm the password and security question for password recovery.
After creating an account or signing in, create a project.
This includes first the project name.
Next, the image calibration number, which is the outside diameter of the needle being used in the experiment.
We recommend that you measure the diameter of the needle with a micrometer before starting the experiment to ensure proper calibration.
Next, the differential density, which is the density difference between the liquid and the outer gas or liquid.
In this case, we are doing water and air, so we can leave it at its default value.
In case you are doing liquid and liquid measurements, example oil and water, the value will be the density of oil being used minus the density of water.
And finally, the acceleration of gravity.
The default value is 9.8. If you wish to provide a more precise value, you can.
Select the injection mode depending on if you ordered the automatic dispenser hardware add-on.
Click on the newly created project and enter image capture screen.
Now put the phone inside the phone holder.
Click on the blue image capture button and adjust the distance from the needle.
We manipulate the orange box to select the area of interest before adjusting the focus on the image.
Generate a droplet as a reference.
Use the focus slider to focus on the droplet to get the best results.
The focus slider should ideally be as close to the maximum value possible.
The aim is to be as close to the droplet as possible without losing focus.
Adjust the LED backlight and the phone's light to get the best possible contrast between the droplet and the background.
Generate a droplet large enough that it is sufficiently deformed by gravity. A nice teardrop shape is recommended.
It's best to aim for a droplet that's just about to detach from the needle.
Move the orange points to the left and right of the needle and hit calibrate.
If the calibration number is green, then the number is correct. If it's red or yellow, then something is wrong.
Generally, the lower the calibration number, the better.
Now move the orange vertical bar to where the droplet meets the needle and the two points to both sides of the droplet and hit calculate.
This will give you the surface tension, the volume, and the cross-sectional area.
Now we will demonstrate how to use multi-capture for dynamic surface tension measurement.
The app's multi-capture function can be used to take multiple images in a set time frame.
This can be used as a foolproof way of measuring the surface tension by generating the droplet slowly and taking the image right before it detaches from the needle.
It can also be used to measure the dynamic surface tension.
Simply specify the number of images to capture and the duration of capture.
Once you are ready, hit the capture button and start generating the droplet.
Go to one of the images, do the entire calculation process, including calibration.
Then go back and hit calculate all to process all the images captured in this time frame.
A few features that can be accessed from the project screen.
The project parameters can be edited.
You can load external images into the project.
You can also run a video slideshow of the images in the project in chronological order.
The calculated data can be saved per your preference in settings.
You can choose if you want to store the data on the SD card.
You can also choose to save on your preferred cloud service.
We currently support Google Drive, Dropbox, Microsoft OneDrive, and Box.
We also allow you to easily report an issue from within the app via email.
To archive a project, long press the project and hit Archive.
Archived projects can be accessed from the settings screen.